Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to get some handy information from shell scripts in the terminal and turn that into a notification you can bring up with a key press. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you probably already know that you could find some useful information if you go into Terminal and use Terminal commands, also called shell scripts, to get this information and display it in the Terminal. But you can also use Automator to call these same commands. And then since you're in Automator, you can present that as a notification. So let's look at an example that will display three useful pieces of information whenever you need them. So I'm going to start off here in Terminal looking at the information that we're going to get. The first thing that we're going to get is really easy. It's just simply the date and time. Now, why would you want to use that? I mean, you probably already have the date and time at the top of your screen, right? Well, sometimes, like with me, I don't like to display the date. It takes up too much space here. But when I want to know the date, I have to go up here and click and look at the full date. Other people don't even like to display the time. They don't always want to have a clock in their face. So in the terminal, a simple command, date, will give you all that information. Not only that, but you can customize the format. So for instance, I can do date and then in quotes put a plus, and then certain symbols like percent %A will give me the day of the week. I could do the same thing, capital Y instead of capital A gives me the year. Now if I want to use the much longer string, this, that will format the date to look like this, which is a nice format to present. If you really want to know all the different ways you can format the date, if you do manual, M-A-N, and then date, the command we're using, you go into the manual here. And you can see right here that the input format parsed using something called strp time. So if you do a Google search on strp time, you come up with tons of pages that will spell out all the different formatting options. Now let's take a look at the next thing we want to get. I want to know the name of the Wi-Fi network I'm on. Now you can do this using a command in the terminal called network setup. And you can see there's a ton of different information that comes up here when you say network setup. It just basically tells you how to use it. So let's look at an example. Here I'm going to use this command, network setup -get airport network space EN2. And what I get here is current Wi-Fi network colon, and it tells me the name of a Wi-Fi network. In this case I'm using my iPhone to connect, not my regular Wi-Fi network. Now where'd that EN2 come from? Well, you have different interfaces for connection to the internet. You've got Ethernet, you've got Wi-Fi, possibly things like Thunderbolt, all sorts of stuff. If you go into About This Mac and then System Report and then down to Network, you'll see here different active services. And I could see here, for instance, EN0 is my Ethernet connection. EN11 is a direct connection to my iPhone if it's plugged in. And EN2 is my Wi-Fi. So EN2, the BSD device name for my Wi-Fi network, that's what I want to use. It may be different on yours. Maybe EN0 or EN1. Of course, you could always just check. If you go in and say EN0, you're not going to get a valid result. So you can do EN1. That doesn't give you a valid result either. EN2, bingo, there you go. Now I don't want to use current Wi-Fi network colon space before it. So I'm going to modify this a little. If I pipe this command, this is a pipe right here, if I pipe this command through AWK, I can look for the colon space and get everything after it. So now that command gives me just the exact name of the Wi-Fi network. So this is handy to have, especially if you move around a lot with your MacBook Pro and you want to quickly see what Wi-Fi network you're on without having to go into the menus here and look. Now the third piece of information I want to get is my IP address. Now if you get your local IP address, you're going to get the IP address for the router or Wi-Fi network that you're on. You want to get the IP address out on the internet. So what other devices see you as, like when you're connecting to a web server or something like that, what IP address do they think you're coming from? This is really handy for a lot of people, especially in office situations where they need to know their IP address for security reasons. The only way to really get that is to actually call out to a website and ask it to tell you what the IP address is. And there are a ton of different websites that will return this information. So here's one. I'm just going to use curl, which is a way to go out and call out and get a URL, get information, kind of like loading a web page. But this is a very simple web page that just returns the IP address in a plain text format. So when I type that, you can see it gives me the IP address. So there are the three types of information that I want to get. So let's do that using Automator. I'm going to use Automator because I want to make this a quick action so I can easily assign a keyboard shortcut to it. So here we go, quick action, and I'll choose that. Now, to use these commands, all I need to do is search for shell, and you can see there's run shell script. I could drag that in here. Now, I could set the type of shell I want. By default, yours might be set to bash. I'm going to set to Z shell because this is the default now on macOS Catalina. The shells are very similar to each other, like slightly different dialects of the same language. But every once in a while something won't work if you're not using the proper shell. So I'm going to use Z shell for all of these. So first I'm going to paste in the date command here. So this is going to return the value for this. I can look at results and see what the results are here. Before I run it, I'm going to set workflow receives no input because I don't need any input in any application. Now let's try it out. When I hit run, you can see the results here are that date. Great, so it's working. Now what I want to do is put these results into a variable. So I'm going to search here for variable and I'm going to use set value of variable. And I'm going to put that as a connected action here after run shell script. I'm going to click on create new variable and assign this variable a name. I'll just call it date. And I'll hit done. And now you can see at the bottom it lists the variables I've got. If you don't see that here, make sure you click on this button. If you're on this button here, you're going to get a log. This button will give you variables. So this will set the value of the variable date to the result of the shell script. Now let's do it for the other two. So I'll do run shell script again and I'll add this to the bottom here. I can control click here and ignore input. So disconnect this. So this is a pair of actions that won't run together. Now I'm going to start another pair. This shell script is going to be the one that gets my IP address. So I'll do it like that and then I'm going to do variable set value of variable. Stick that underneath here and I'm going to select a new variable and call that IP address. And now I'm going to do this for a third time. I'm going to do run shell script. I'm going to put it underneath here. I'm going to control click here, ignore input. And I'm going to use the script that will get the Wi-Fi network. And I'm going to store that in a variable. And I'll call that Wi-Fi. So now I have those three variables there. So now what we need to do is display them in a notification. Now, Automator has something for this. If I search for notification, you can see display notification. So there are two good reasons to use Automator for this. One is that I can easily assign this as a service with a keyboard shortcut, which we'll do in a minute. The other is this display notification action makes things really easy. So I'll add this here at the bottom. I'm going to ignore input from above this. Now I need to fill these in. Let's assign a title and I'll call this current information. I can have a subtitle under it and a message. So this is perfect for three pieces of information. In the subtitle, let's go ahead and put the date. So instead of actually typing there, I'm going to drag the date from there up. Now for message, I'm going to drag Wi-Fi here, but I can still type in this field. So I'm going to hit a space, put a slash, another space, and then I'm going to drag IP address. Now message is just one line. So if I tried to put all three of these things in the message, it would be too long. So it's perfect that I have the date as the subtitle of this. And the message is Wi-Fi slash IP address. Let's run this and see what happens. There's my notification. It says current information, there's the date, there's my Wi-Fi network, and there's my IP address. All displayed there in a quick notification. And I can close it. Now since I've already set this up as a quick action, all I need to do is do file save. And I can save this as something like show current info. And hit save. Now this will show up in Quick Actions as a service for anything because I set it for any application. So for instance, I'll click on the background here. I'm in Finder and I'll go to Finder Services and there's Show Current Info. And if I select it there, it will bring up that notification right here. If this is the first time running the service in the Finder, you may actually get a dialog asking you for permission to do so. Now let's go into System Preferences. And I'm going to go and set the keyboard shortcuts under services. I'm going to look under general here. There's show current info and I can set a shortcut. So let's do something like command F1. And now that I've set it to command F1, I can hit command F1 and it brings up the information right there. And it did that in system preferences. I can do that in the Finder. I can bring that up. I can do it in any app. Although I may get asked permission sometimes if it's the first time I'm doing it inside of a certain app. But eventually you won't have those anymore and command F1 will bring up this information anytime you need it. Now also notice that every time it brings it up I have to go over here and close it. Well, if I want it to just appear for a second and then go away on its own, I can go into System Preferences and then to Notifications, and then I can look for Automator here on the left. And I could set the style. Instead of an alert, I can have it appear as a banner. So when I change that, look what happens. It will come up and then it will go away on its own after a few seconds. Just like that. So this is just an example. These are three pieces of information that I could find handy to appear here in a notification like this. But if you use the terminal to get other pieces of information, or you have shell scripts that generate other information, you can include them in here just as easily and have them appear as a quick notification with a keyboard shortcut. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.